dog treats because they deserve nothing but the best. Isn't that right? Before we get into making our dog cookies, let's touch on the dog food industry real quick and why we're making our own cookies rather than going to the store and buying your typical milk bone. The dog food industry is self-regulated, which means that the people who profit off of dog food are also the people making the rules around how dog food is made, which means that they do not care about the health of your furry friend, they care about the profits. As a human, you pick up a milk bone and no part of you wants to eat it because the dog food industry uses the byproduct of all different kinds of animals from slaughterhouses that is unsafe for human consumption. Dog food and dog treats are cooked at such a high temperature and completely dehydrated that all of the nutrients are stripped out. It'd be like eating Doritos for every single meal for your entire life. Now, I'm not making this video to make you feel bad about how you're caring for your pet, but it's now you know. So once you know, you can start to make little changes. And a really great way to make a tiny little change is to start making your own dog treats. I know that everyone doesn't have the time or the funds to make all of your dog food from scratch, but the more fresh food that you can give your dog, the better off your dog will be. So with that, let's make some fresh cookies for your dog from all natural, wholesome ingredients that I know your pup will love. So the first thing I want to touch base on when we make these cookies is peanut butter. There's a lot of things out there saying that peanut butter is bad for your dogs, but the only thing in peanut butter that is bad for your dog is anything that's in this other than peanuts. And I'm talking about salts, I'm talking about added sugars, preservatives, chemicals. If you can't pronounce it, you shouldn't be eating it and your dog shouldn't be eating it either. So make sure when you look on the ingredients of your label, all you see is peanuts and make sure that it's non-GMO too. All right, let's make some dog cookies. I'm not gonna measure out everything super specifically because luckily for your dog, they'll like it either way. So I've got one mashed apple. I just popped this in my blender for a few minutes. If you want, you can get unsweetened applesauce as well. That works really good. So I'm just gonna add this to my bowl. And then I've got two shredded carrots that I'm also gonna add right in there. I'm gonna mix this around. And then I'm gonna add about a cup of peanut butter. Okay, so now that we've added all of our wet ingredients, we're gonna add some chopped mint. I love adding chopped mint because it's super healthy for your dog and it really helps with stinky breath. So it's a really like simple and healthy way to improve that like really nasty puppy breath. All right, next up we're gonna add a half cup of brown rice flour or quinoa flour. Either one works really well for this recipe. Or oat flour would actually work too. And then finally, I'm just gonna add about a half cup of rolled oats. The rolled oats will help them stick together and they're super filling for your pup too. And since we are giving these to our pups, we don't need to add any baking soda or any baking powder. Both of those things can actually be toxic to our dogs. So it's totally unnecessary, even if you're making like a birthday cake for your dog or anything like that, it doesn't need to fully rise. Just let it do its thing without baking soda or baking powder. Just a little tip.
Best part is the cookie dough.
Fahrenheit for 12 to 15 minutes until they're crispy on the outside but still kind of soft and chewy on the inside. They're done! Let them cool and then put them onto a plate and keep them in the refrigerator for storing. If you made way too many of a really small dog, you'll probably break it up into a few pieces, keep them in the freezer, and they'll store just right. If you guys liked this video and want to see more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment. And if you want to know more about dog food, and how I feed my dog, comment below and I'll make sure to add more videos and recipes like this in the lineup. Grab them. Stand tall. Stand tall.
You want more?